This, I think, was a mistake. And let me preface as well. I'm a Michigan guy. I went to Michigan. I was watching
that
game
Forgive
on Saturday. And I saw that hit, and it was a pretty significant hit. It's not an exact science to diagnose a concussion, but I can tell you, anybody who was watching that probably noticed that it was a very big hit. He was down on the ground for a period of time, and then eventually was motioned out because a neurologist on the sideline, Brooke, saw that he was stumbling around. Wasn't entirely sure, obviously, whether he had suffered a concussion because he hadn't examined him yet. He was brought out of the game. What I understand, I read the same statement from the athletic director that you did, that neurologist was to examine Shane Morris before he went back in, and because of some miscommunication, that didn't happen, and this player, who had just taken this big hit, was put back in the game. Let me say as well that they make a big point of saying, look, the concussion wasn't clear, it wasn't even clear post-game. That's fine. Again, this is not an exact science, but one of the mantras that people have talked about who've been very serious about this issue for some time is, when in doubt, you sit it out, because
right.
this is not the sort of thing you want to take a chance with. If somebody takes a second hit after suffering a concussion, we're not talking about just being out for a few seconds. We're talking about having a catastrophic brain injury, even dying from that. That's second impact syndrome, and that's exactly what you're trying to prevent. And I think that they fell down on the job when it came to this particular player.
Here's what I don't get. I don't understand how, you know, as many times you have been on the television explaining the dangers, explaining these hits, explaining when in doubt, sit it out, yet something is still obviously being lost in translation, that this is still happening at the college level and perhaps beyond.
Yeah, and it's a little bit befuddling given how important this is. Now, you saw Coach Brady Hoke there talking about the fact that he's got incredible, you know, the welfare of the players is his concern, and I think that's true. I think that he's also not the guy in a position to be able to say, you know, does this player have a concussion? Are we worried about him to bench him or not? Mm-hmm. There was significant miscommunication on the sideline. You had a neurologist there who said, look, I'm concerned, let's pull this player. He does come out. Apparently the neurologist is coming down to examine him to make a decision, and he's put back in before that examination takes place. That just is not right. I will tell you, just because I'm a football fan, the other quarterback that went in got his helmet knocked off. And by NCAA rules, he's got to sit out the next play when you get your helmet knocked off. They could have brought in a third string quarterback at that point, but instead they put in Shane Morris again, the guy that just got, you know, a significant blow to the head. And I think that was the mistake, Brooke.